Here we're going to consider steady state, one-dimensional flow in the z direction over a single stationary vertical plate, and it's exposed to atmospheric pressure. And what we want to know, given this coordinate system, is what is the velocity profile, W of x, for this type of flow. So to develop a velocity profile for this particular system, we're going to use the Navier-Stokes equation, simplify it, and then use boundary conditions to solve for it. So let's start simplifying our Navier-Stokes. First of all, we know that it's steady state, so this is going to be zero. We know that it is one-dimensional, therefore u and v are going to be equal to zero, so we're going to get rid of every term that has a u or a v. We assume that the flow is fully developed. In other words, w is not a function of z, and that's going to be equal to zero. In addition, it's atmospheric pressure, which means that the pressure does not change with respect to z. It's going to be the same throughout, so that's zero. We know just by looking at it that the velocity is going to change in the x direction, so we're going to need to include this term, but it doesn't change in the y direction and it doesn't change in the z direction. Our gravity is in the negative z direction, so what we're going to be left with here is that zero is equal to minus rho density times the gravity in the z direction plus mu, the viscosity, d squared w dx squared. And we can write this as well as d squared w dx squared is equal to rho g sub z divided by mu. So to find our velocity profile, we'll need to integrate this expression twice. So we start with dw dx is going to be equal to rho g sub z mu x plus c1. There's our first constant. And then we integrate it again so that we get our w of x, which is going to be equal to rho g sub z divided by 2 mu x squared plus c1 times x plus c2. So since we have two constants, we're going to need two boundary conditions to solve for the velocity profile. So let's look at these two boundary conditions and we'll go back to here. So we're going to call this right here x equals 0. And right here, we're going to call this that x equals some l. So if we look at the first part, x equals 0, because it's a stationary plate, due to no slip conditions, w has to also equal zero. Now, if we look at L, which is the interface between the liquid and the air outside, we know at the interface that there can't be any shear stresses. So mu dw dx equals zero, or we can write that dw dx equals zero at this x equal to L. So now let's use these boundary conditions. So the first one we're going to use at x equals zero, w equals zero. And if we put that into this equation, this is zero, this is zero, that's zero. Therefore, our C2 is going to be equal to zero. Now let's put our second boundary condition here. into this equation. So we have dw dx, and we're going to say that it equals 0 rho g sub z divided by mu at some L plus C1. And so what that allows us to find now is our C1, which is going to be equal to minus rho g sub z divided by mu times L. So let's put that all into our equation for our W of X, which is right here. So our velocity profile, W of X, is going to be equal to rho G sub Z divided by mu X squared divided by 2 minus X times L. And all I did there was combine terms and pull the rho g sub z divided by mu out of the equation. So let's make sure this actually satisfies our boundary condition. So if we plug in x equals 0, will w equal 0? And hopefully you can see by putting x equals 0 in that yes, it will equal, w will equal 0. Now let's look at the second part. So I'll rewrite this. dw dx is equal to rho g z divided by mu times x plus our c1, which is minus rho g z mu times L. And this has to be equal to 0. So if you look at this, what you see is that x minus L equals 0, and therefore the derivative of w with respect to x does equal 0 at x equals L, so there are no shear stresses at the interface between the film and the air.